We are just a few miles from the Gulf Coast of Florida at Raymond James Stadium here in Tampa. Just a short time ago, the Buccaneers emerging from their tunnel to the roar of this frenzied crowd here in the Sunshine State. And we're in the big ship, and fittingly, everyone here ready to do battle as Tampa Bay gets ready to match up with the San Francisco 49ers. Throwing on first is Garoppolo. Hooking up here with Trent Taylor. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. Nice way to start the drive. A gain of 12 and a first down.
I think it all came together there. In breaking route. Drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Now a man who really stepped up last year. This is Matt Breida. And he'll get this one up to about the 39 here. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. Matt Breida out of Georgia Southern now in his third year in a 49er uniform. He was tough to keep off the field last year. Very good yards per carry. 5.3 on 153 attempts. Good for over 800 yards rushing. A first carry for the former Falcon, Tevin Coleman. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. The second down play results in a loss of 2 yards. It's probably a pretty good sign here on the opening drive if your guys from the secondary are coming up and spilling things in the backfield.
How about the adrenaline and aggressiveness that led his eyes to the backfield to run up there and make that tackle, setting a tone early for his defense.
Now Garoppolo. Open man is Kendrick Bourne. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. The completion good for only 6, and that'll bring up 4th.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping him from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. And that one hits a little too close to the goal line, and it continues into the end zone for a touchback.
As Tampa Bay's offense trots out here, Charles, let's look ahead to this season. You know, you and I have talked before about Marcus Mariota and this being a big year for him in Tennessee. Well, his draft mate, Jameis Winston, this is kind of a big year for him under center.
You're exactly right. Both of them in their 5th year. Remember, Winston was the number 1 pick in that draft. Mariota was number 2. And it's not that Jameis Winston hasn't been coached and coach well before. He's had quarterback gurus in his career at Tampa, but now Bruce Arians, the head coach, that may be the ultimate quarterback guru. And also his offensive coordinator is a former quarterback in the NFL. So if it doesn't happen this year for him, I don't know when it does, but the early returns seem promising. He looked pretty good in the early going.
Operating from the 27 now, here's 2nd and 3. Now Winston, and this is caught by Evans. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. 2 plays, 2 catches. You have a feeling they're going to look for him early and often, and that's to be expected. You got a player of his caliber, why not?
And I think it's also a message from them to the defense that you're not going to dictate to us what we're going to do with one of our better players, because so often you hear about defenses saying we're going to take away what you do best. In this case, they're going to move him around, find proper matchups, and make sure they continue to funnel the ball to him.
8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on 2nd and short. Ready. 8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's 2nd and a couple. Winston. There's the Penn State man. It's Chris Godwin. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers 41-yard line.
Chris Godwin, the former Penn Stater, should see an increase in action and production in 2019 with Adam Humphries and DeSean Jackson gone from the team. 842 yards in 2018, second only to Mike Evans on the Buccaneers.
This is Peyton Barber. He led them in rushing a season ago. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Come on. Watch left.
He's
stopped right there.
Hey. On second and nine, Winston. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
I think we'll see more of them trying to get him the football out of the backfield. They love what he can do in open space, and they believe that he creates mismatches they can exploit.
First down marker at the 31. It's third down. Working out of the gun, Winston. He's got Evans. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers 23.
Well, I know from past experience, before you actually play a game, you visualize what's going to happen. And I don't know anyone who doesn't visualize themselves being in the center of what's going on. That's three catches for him here in the early going. He's got to like the way this is starting.
Absolutely. Three catches on any drive is good. Opening drive, that's a tone setter. A first down throw for Winston. Godwin's got it. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Chris Godwin there to make the grab. And they are able to strike first here on their opening drive. An ideal start for them, really. You force the punt, and then you go down and score.
And you've got to see a fist pump on the sideline from the head coach, don't you? Because he's turning to his bench, and he's telling his team, this is how we prepare. Force the punt, go downfield and score. I told you guys, it's just like a boxer in the gym preparing for the fight. Now we get to turn it all loose.
Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
San Francisco's offense taking the field here. And folks, you'd be impressed with my partner Charles Davis's preseason schedule. He gets all over the place. Every camp, he's just always in the air in a camp. So what are you hearing from the Niners camp and Jimmy Garoppolo and company?
Well, you know, I try to be America's guest.
And
that's
how
it works. I do as best I can with that. But with Jimmy Garoppolo, the recovery has been great. Everyone loves what they're seeing. In OTAs and minicamp, he actually took a snap and one went to throw a football, and whistles went like crazy because a couple of pass rushers came free even though there was no contact. Anyone who came near him, they just stopped the play immediately. Then you get into the fall camp, and they actually have a trick play where Jimmy Garoppolo ultimately becomes the receiver. And head coach Kyle Shanahan has taken that play out of the playbook. We're not going to have Jimmy Garoppolo doing those sort of things while he continues to recover.
Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete. The threat of a second straight punt to start the game is looming as they come up third and 10. Working from the gun, Garoppolo. The throw to the left side, caught by Coleman. And a good tackle there right around the 30. Stops him short of the first down.
A short game that doesn't get him the first down brings up a fourth down situation.
Really nice job defensively. They knew where the sticks were. They got the stop before it. Here comes the 49ers punter now as he'll punt it away for the second time. Fielded just inside the 20. Just a yard return there after a punt of 49. And the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. Here comes the Tampa Bay offense now heading back out onto the field. Now they'll be looking to duplicate the efforts of drive number one that resulted in 7 points in the 7-zip lead.
Well, you know how much I enjoy horse racing, right? Looks like they caught a flyer out of the gate, as they would say when you're running the big-time races. Means they get out to a fast start. They're setting the pace, making the other team chase now.
A little bit of daylight on that first down run sets him up nicely. 8 yards on the carry. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and two.
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Line of scrimmage, the 28 now, as they come up on second and a couple. On play action, Winston. Looking for Evans, and it's intercepted. Able to get there and pick it. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line. They'll run with Coleman on first down. Oh, he's got a little daylight. The 20. And across the chalk, into the end zone. It's a 49er touchdown. Tevin Coleman, 44 yards, as they are now on the board here in the first half. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
Gold able to tack on the extra point, and we are tied at 7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Fielded about a yard deep. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive followed by an interception last time out.
Now, it sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, it balances it out. And we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that sting lingers a little bit longer. Got to come out now and put together some nice plays.
And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. They go back to the ground. This time, Barber. Not much there. Maybe a couple up to the 35.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
3rd and short yardage, Winston. And he's got a man. It's the tight end, Howard, complete. 13 yards on his first catch. It's a first down as well.
And with the Buccaneers' new coaching staff, you have to figure they're going to want to use O.J. Howard a little bit more this season. 34 catches, 565 yards last year, but that was in only 10 games. 6'6", 251, and can run. Find a way to get him the ball, as they just did there.
On first down, nothing opening up really on the running play. Give him maybe a yard, and it'll be 2nd down. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense, because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
Only 3 yards on the catch. It's 3rd down.
Hey!
They had the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all. And now they're looking at third down here. From the gun, Winston. He's got his tight end over the middle, O.J. Howard. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers' 27-yard line.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there were more people there to get him down.
Jameis to throw it. Throw right side, taken in by Godwin. A gain of six there on first. Well, this is how you shake the thoughts of that interception on the last drive. You come out and start this one 4-for-4.
And watching him throw it around with that type of confidence reminds me of a guy I played with way back when who told me, I don't care if I throw 10 interceptions in a row, I'm going to stay confident, keep flinging it. I just figured there's something wrong with the football.
Going for Evans, but that pass is intercepted. It's the former Seahawk, Richard Sherman. Well, Charles, while we have a moment, you know what we need to do here is give a nod to the new Hall of Famers who were brought into Canton and inducted on August the 3rd. Champ Bailey, Pat Bowlen, Gil Brandt, Tony Gonzalez, Ty Law, Kevin Mawai, Ed Reed, and Johnny Robinson, all part of the class.
Fantastic class. When you talk about guys who played at a top level, obviously, they're Hall of Famers. But what I found interesting about it is you've got a great pass catcher, the best pass catching tight end in history in Tony Gonzalez. How would he like to work against this secondary? Champ Bailey and Ty Law at corner, Ed Reed and Johnny Robinson at safety. Good luck trying to get open against those four. What a matchup that would have been, but it was a terrific night for those gentlemen. Congratulations. And of course, Ed Reed's bust will go down in history because they got the hair exactly right. And Ed had a ball up there in his Hall of Fame speech.
And remember, next year, they're going to celebrate the centennial year of the NFL with a special class of 20. So get ready for those speeches.
I wonder if they'll do it like Johnny Robinson this year, who actually submitted a video instead of going up to the podium. And his speech was about 5 minutes long, which is probably about the right length.
Here comes the 49ers punter now, standing about a yard deep in his own end zone. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And taken right at the 35. A good return there, call it 13 yards. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Here comes the Tampa Bay offense now heading back out onto the field. And two interceptions already here in this first half. That's got to affect him a little bit, right? He's got to be thinking about it.
He's got to be thinking about it, but most of the good ones, they find a way to put it aside. They're not happy about it by any stretch of the imagination. They find a way to put it aside and continue to play their game.
Can he put it aside? Let's find out. The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And two picks thrown here in this first half alone. We'll see how that affects him.
Can't wait to see where his confidence is, because the great ones, they'll throw four or five picks, and while it'll hurt their team, it won't hurt their confidence. They'll think something was just wrong with the ball or the wind or something was funny. It's never about them. That's how they stay so into the moment and into the game.
And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. So a jump there defensively.
And it's a killer. Watch the football. Don't move across the line of scrimmage until the ball moves.
They will come up on a first and 5 following the encroachment penalty. From the shotgun, it's Winston. And break, the tight end's got it. The Bucs forced to use their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number one. Here's Matt Gay now for the Bucks field goal. From the left hash, it's a 36-yard attempt. Gay's kick is good. And they take the lead here now at 10-7. Now the drive ends in just three, but they'll take it. Looks like they'll head to the locker room, barring something unfortunate, in front on the scoreboard.
Yeah, they may not be jumping up and down and celebrating because they have the lead, but still, any little momentum in a game like this is important to a team, and they'll feel real good about going in and regrouping, knowing that they are out in front.
The punter, Pinion, now to kick this one away. This one fielded at the five. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. The San Francisco offense getting their last-minute instructions before they take over here. Likely time for just one final play, and then it'll be off to the locker room to talk about how they can erase this deficit.
Yeah, and I think a lot of people look at it and go, well, maybe you take a shot here. Maybe you get some momentum going into the half. What's the flip side of that? You do something crazy, quarterback gets hit, ball comes free, and now you're down an even bigger margin. Go ahead and take this one. Go to the locker room. Start over.
We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
It's in the game.
This will be fielded at the six. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Out come the Buccaneers. They'll have it first to start in the third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace, because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. First down, they go with Barber again. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. 10 yards there and a Buccaneer first down.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. Back-to-back good plays, have them on the move on first down. Winston. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. Well, let's have some fun while we have a minute here. Fantasy drafts are in full swing. I know I've got my family fantasy draft coming up, Charles. Who would be your top three picks? I know that you're a noted fantasy football expert, so who would you take?
Well, you've got to start with guys who are going to touch the football and put it in the end zone, right? You got to score points. How about Saquon Barkley with the Giants? You know he's going to run it. He's going to catch it. When they get desperate, they may actually have him return it as well. Yeah, Alvin Kamara is an absolute matchup nightmare for everyone. And Christian McCaffrey, did he ever come off the field last year? And, you know, this guy, he's a threat to be a 1,000-yard runner and a 1,000-yard receiver, as is Kamara. So this is going to be fun to watch. I can't wait to see those guys do their thing. But there are plenty of other guys out there, too. If Zeke comes along, you got to take him. Melvin Gordon, if they both come to camp, we'll see how that works out. How about Todd Gurley and his health? Because, boy, when he touches the ball, great things usually happen.
And then wondering, someone like Le'Veon Bell took the year off, now a new offense. But if he starts going like he used to, he's obviously going to be a good one.
Fresh legs is what you're counting on with Le'Veon Bell and a fresh start in New York with the Jets. And if you're looking for an exciting rookie, remember this. Kyler Murray's going to get the ball from the first snap, and they're going to leave him in there throughout. And as long as he stays healthy, he's going to pitch it around the park a bunch. Don't be surprised if he gets a little love, too.
It's easy work, and it's coming again.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
facing a second and two after that last catch. Good for 8 yards.
It's just me and you.
And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
We've seen good cover skills on display throughout this game, really from both teams. And there's another nice example there of them making it difficult to complete a pass.
Ready. Trying to keep the drive going here. This is play number 7 on 3rd and 2. They'll try and run here with Barber. Well, they hit him in the backfield, and he will not escape. And that is not going to get it done. That'll bring up 4th. They had the 8-yard gain on 1st down, but unable to do much from there.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the 3rd quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
And Gay knocks this one through. And the lead stretches to 6 here. It's 13-7. Maybe a little fortunate there. That was leaking a little, maybe leaking a lot, but he got it.
Yeah, he actually was able to make it work. How about the body language, though, right? As he watched that ball leak to the right, trying to bring it back in, and had just enough to get it done.
The punter Pinion now to kick this one away. This fielded at the 2. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Here's a look at the 49ers offense as they make their way out for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half 2.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
And never good on a pass completion there to go the wrong way, lost yardage.
No, for some reason, it seems to work better when you throw it downfield or you move the ball downfield running it that way, doesn't it? But in this case, if you're the defensive guys, you're energized, executed well, and you caused a lost yardage play. That's going to feel good and look great in film.
And he'll be brought down right around the 37. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face 3rd down.
Let's just break this down and make it pretty simple. Key to the drag route, letting the play develop, finding the hole in the defense, and giving your athlete, yes, athlete, a chance to make something happen once he has the ball in his hands.
They'll try to pick this up on the ground with Breida, and he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. First down, San Francisco, the pickup, 14 yards. Although his reputation as a speedy runner precedes him, it's always fun to watch him work.
It is eye-opening, isn't it? Because when you see him get the ball and just go, in addition to that speed, it helps out his blockers. They don't have to hold blocks for long because he's just going to speed.
Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 46. Devin White gets him for a loss of 5. He is so tough to handle on the blitz, and that's Exhibit A. Got to assume this defense will be charging again here. It's 2nd and 15. Garoppolo now looking middle, and it's incomplete. He was looking that time for Dante Pettis, and it's 3rd down. Trying to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. Garoppolo after the fake give to Breida. And that one incomplete. They try to sneak in a deep ball with the clock running down, but to no avail as time will expire on this 3rd quarter of play. Here comes the 49ers punter now.
He's been terrific so far. Now the Buccaneers offensive unit back out on the field. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it? Touchdowns.
They'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. An excellent way to start the drive there, 18 yards.
I got the sense that the defense created a little momentum for them there, didn't it?
Did their job, forced the punt. Now, nice start to the drive. Offense has to do their part.
Yeah, they certainly do, but what a great start for them. They got to go thank the guys on D.
Now left side, a completion to his tight end. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
And, partner, I think that was a great example that not all tight ends are created equal because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
Second and five after the five-yard completion on first down. Here's Winston. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
While we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore, I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion and both sides trying to get to the football and you're holding your breath wondering whether it's going to go good or bad for your team.
And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. A free 5 yards as the defense jumps.
I know it's an anticipation game for them, but it's also a reaction game, and they reacted poorly on that one.
Ready. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. On third down, here comes Barber. Breaks the tackle, he's got room to run. Touchdown, Tampa Bay! Peyton Barber, 39 yards as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. So they went to the ground game on third, hoping to pick up the first. They also picked up a touchdown.
Offensive linemen so used in this situation to having a pass block. All right, you're looking at what it is, third down. They don't care that it's third and whatever. They figure they're going to throw the ball. And when you call a running play, I think you energize them. I think you juice them up because I haven't met offensive linemen yet that likes to pass block more than they like to run block. And they opened up some nice holes there for him, and he took it to the house.
Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. This fielded at the 2. He'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. The intended receiver, Marquise Goodwin. And that'll bring up second down.
When you can count on one hand the number of completions you've had in a game and we're in the second half, that tells you it's really not been your day.
Yeah, but you're losing. You can't just abandon the passing game altogether.
Yeah, maybe you can get hot, string a few together, and get rolling.
Garoppolo to try again on second down. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. 7 yards on the play, and that's going to lead to a third down.
One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Garoppolo looks to throw, and that is incomplete.
Well, the other day they told us when we've got third and five or less, we have to be able to convert. And I guess every team would say that, Charles, but an opportunity miss there.
What they were trying to tell us is they believe it's a matchup game at that point, and they liked some matchups that they had, thought they could exploit them, unable to do so on that play.
Garoppolo to throw for it on four. And no, it's incomplete.
The Niners go for it, but it doesn't work out. And the Bucs are going to take over with excellent field position to boot. So they really needed points here in a two-score game. Could not come away with anything there on fourth.
And while we know they're a little bit discouraged here, they can't check out of this game. You and I have called a good number of games over the course of our career where we've seen these types of situations. Teams get the ball back, and that miracle.
And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown.
Mike Evans, 31 yards as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And your first thought is there bad blood that went into this one ahead of time, that maybe they're seeking some revenge or they just don't like him? But the other thing that always hits me is, are they worried about playoff positioning, right? Are they worried about, do you need enough points in case there's a tiebreaker that comes into play later?
Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. This is taken at his four. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. The 49ers offense making its way back out there. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned it to 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down
caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for him. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain, so now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
So they'll take the yardage and tack on 15 more for the face mask.
Talk about a play that absolutely costs you in the end. Just trying to do your job, right? Trying to get him on the ground. Next thing you know, they'll march off another 15 against your squad.
Here we go. It's first and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. A shotgun snap for Garoppolo. Deep ball for Goodwin. It's caught at the 10. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. Marquise Goodwin, 45 yards. And the 49ers get a score closer. And he showcased his blazing speed on that one.
Was he wearing football cleats or track spikes? Because he was gone. Big time play, and just think about what that does if you're a receiver on the team with him. Well, that's got to open things up for you as well, because if I'm a defense, I've got to get back deeper and deeper in order to keep him in front. But I'm not sure how many can actually keep him in front with that speed.
Two scores down, three timeouts left. Still a chance if they can somehow get this one back. And the Buccaneers able to recover. Their hands team does its job. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical. Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making him.
And they're going to get him. He's taken down for a sack back at the 47-yard line. Nick Bosa. He's the one that got home and takes him down for a loss of 9. Winston needing a big play after the sack as he leads the Bucs up on 3rd and long.
I'm letting you know right now, you better break.
Throwing, Winston. And this is going to be caught, but they'll say out of bounds. So it's incomplete. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. Here's Bradley Pinion now, as he's on a punt for the first time this afternoon. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. Garoppolo and the Niners now down by 12, 2:13 remaining. They have all three timeouts and the two-minute warning, but they need two scores.
Here we go, here we go.
Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here first and 10 at the 20. From the gun, it's Garoppolo. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete.
Yeah, that one sailed on him. You've got to make sure you give your receiver a chance to come down inbounds, because they are very gifted. They'll make the circus catches, but if they make them out of bounds, that does you no good.
Here we go.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20.
Here we go, here we go.
There's Garoppolo to throw. Deep ball for Goodwin. And that going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions.
Stay hot.
To throw is Garoppolo. Coleman has it here right side. And he'll get this to the 23, but that'll be well short of what he needed. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. They'll go for it. It's Garoppolo. And down he goes. A Buccaneer sack. Levante David making his presence felt in the backfield. So with that, we can just about close the book on this one, Charles.
Yeah, what's the other expression about slim and none? Well, Slim just left town on that one.
They're down to none?
Yes, exactly right.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. He was looking for Breshad Perriman, and now it's second down. Well, interceptions have been a problem in this one. If he could have gotten his feet down here, it would have been another.
Would have been a huge one. They got a great game taking the ball away. Thought they had another one, just unable to get those cleats inbounds.
To throw on second and 10. Winston to the end zone, but it's incomplete.
I think he's taking an awful chance with the football right there. You've got a lead. You've got to protect it. And he's taking chances putting it out there in a little bit of jeopardy.
Especially in a spot like this, fourth quarter, as you said, trying to cling to that advantage.
Yeah, that one probably should have been picked, huh?
The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is third and long. Winston gives to Barber, and he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. So now here comes the field goal team for the third time today. Gay's kick is good. And that will make this now a 15-point advantage. So they settle for just the three, but clearly right now anything helps trying to salt this one away in the fourth.
Without a doubt. Obviously a touchdown probably would have been the final nail to finish this thing off, but it's still eight up time, got points. So while it's not mission accomplished, it's darn close.
The punter Pinion now to kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. The San Francisco offense getting their last-minute instructions before they take over here. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. But good job by their defense, though. They held them to three, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than three. And that's exactly what happened there.
You think that factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
Hey, ball on the 30 as they come up second and 10. Looking to throw, Garoppolo. And that's off the mark, incomplete. He started out having some troubles back in the first half connecting with his receivers. Really hasn't gotten a whole lot better.
Yeah, he's at less than 50%, and you and I both know that just won't do. So I would think about spreading things out, putting it on the receivers, make them win those one-on-one battles on the perimeter and find their way open.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. Open man is Pettis. It's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. That one goes for 24 yards. Well, Pettis is quickly becoming the number one receiving option for Jimmy Garoppolo. Into last year, John Lynch said that they loved the way he closed the season, really came on late. Remember, this is a guy that they traded up to get at number 44 back in 2018 out of the University of Washington. Yeah, he will go out right near the 35-yard line. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Garoppolo again. Throw left side, caught by Goodwin. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. A good pickup there, 21 yards. Clock management, definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
Inside the red zone, it's Garoppolo. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
Here we go. After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10. Again, they'll throw with Garoppolo. To the end zone, but it's incomplete. This drive, which was going so smoothly, all of a sudden it's a little bit of a roadblock here with two straight incompletions.
Yeah, apparently this defense has had enough. Apparently they're saying, no more. We're making a stand right here, right now. But it is third and 10. They've got to get after him one more time.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. To throw, it's Garoppolo. And he's not able to get away. Sacked back at the 22. And no matter what the situation, the O-line just hates that because they feel like they didn't protect little brother back there, right?
Yeah, and that's just so difficult for them because just think about every single play. When you decide to throw the football, you're dealing with some of the best athletes on the planet. You talk about guys, if they weren't playing football, they'd be starting in the NBA at power forward. It's really a difficult task.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off at the 19. He's at the 40. Past the 20, and it's a pick six. He brings it back to the house for a Buccaneer TD. And that one will pretty much erase any hopes of a fourth quarter comeback.
With emphasis, interception, return for touchdown. Door closed, locked, reinforced.
Extra point by Gay is up and good. And the lead opens up now to 22 points. So time has run out on what will be a Tampa Bay victory, and they were buoyed, Charles, by a big second half to put this one on ice.
And I know a lot of people watching this one were thinking to themselves, I'll bet halftime was really interesting. Probably took the paint off the walls with some of the words that were said. But I get the sense it was much more of the adjustments they made. They came in with a game plan that we saw that didn't work in the first half. They made the adjustments necessary, went away from that, and then they got it together, got a spark, and then took off. It's really nice to watch in the second half.